The year was 1998. Retro rock icon Lenny Kravitz decided to release a song called Fly Away. Screamed yeah a lot. It had four distorted power chords, yet somehow didn't rock. It didn't go anywhere. It won a Grammy. Just 1 year later, in 1999, Kravitz decides to dub down on that go-nowhere sound and offers up a cover of the Guess Who's American Woman, also known as Fly Away Part 2. It won a Grammy as well. None of this at all surprising, seeing that we live in a world where Cotton Eye Joe, a techno bluegrass vamp from a Swedish band in 1995, became certified platinum. A world where Trisha Yearwood and Leanne Rimes had the same song on the radio at the very same time. Seriously, don't forget that. And no, the Kravitz monotonous Twins of Terror weren't as bad as Cotton Eye Joe, but they were fucking bad, man. And in the 20 plus years that they've existed on this planet, the human race has been asking one question: which song stinks more? Well, today that question will be answered, but you won't get it spoken from the stage nor read from the page. No, ladies and gentlemen, these two songs will head to the football field. That's right, these two sultans of stink will battle it out on the gridiron in what's being called the great match of mediocrity and the battle of the bullshit. Yes, you are about to watch the first game where the team that stinks more will win. Ladies and gentlemen, who do you got? Is it Fly Away or is it American Woman? Both are real bad, but only one will stink enough to win the Kravitz Bowl. Well, good evening, everybody. The time is finally here. It is the Kravitz Bowl. I'm probably an asshole. Welcome to Countdown to Kickoff, where we're going to be getting you ready for tonight's big game. It's a one-stop shop. Don't go anywhere. We got all the hard-hitting analysis you need to know about tonight's match. And by that, we have no idea what's going to happen. But we're wearing suits, and we're going to talk about what could potentially happen, even though we're not going to be held accountable for anything that we say. Now, unless you live under a rock, you'll have heard the narrative that Fly Away are heavy underdogs in today's match. The Vegas oddmakers have ears, and they know that the high-powered American Woman offense featuring no snare is going to keep Fly Away running all day long. Now, to get a clear understanding of what that no snare offense is going to do to Fly Away, let's head over to our very own Zach, who's at the Telestrator. Zach, what do you got for us, buddy?
Thanks, guys. Grab a pair of headphones, because that's where it's going to be most annoying to hear this. So, let me take it to the board right now. All right, here you got your headphones, of course. You got left and right. Any normal song, you're going to have a snare drum. You're going to have all the drums right up center here. Snare, kick, your cymbals and all that kind of stuff. American Woman takes away the snare completely. No snare in the entire song. Splitting it wide out to two hand claps. They're trying to do some kind of T-Rex thing or something. I don't know what they're thinking. So there's nothing in the center of the field, and these hand claps are just hitting you, slapping you on the side of the head, up and down the field until you get to this portion of the field right here. The relentlessness with these hand claps are just going to wear anybody down, and I think that's what's going to happen out there today. I think it's why American Woman is such a strong contender in this contest today. I think it's going to take it. So anyway, that's all from here. Back to you guys in the studio.
Great stuff, Zach. And you're not alone. Sports radio's been flying the American Woman flag all week. That's not slowing down the Fly Away fans. They say their team stinks and is ready to take home Kravitz Gold. And they're letting the world know about it.
Bobby Brusinelli back here with you on WMTSS Sports Radio. Let me tell you something, folks. Let me tell you something, all right? Fly Away does not want it. Fuck Brusinelli. It's almost as if there's no reason for us to do this at all. Let me tell you something, all right?
That's why Bobby Brusinelli's the best.
Brusinelli doesn't know what he's talking about.
Hey, American Woman stinks. Fly Away fucking stinks.
No way. We got Cliff in Conshohocken. What's up, Cliff?
Bobby, thanks for taking my call. Big fan of the show, but you got this wrong, dead wrong. Fly Away is going to run away with the Kravitz Bowl, and I'll tell you why. With 3 minutes and 41 seconds and nothing.
Fly
the last
away
60
stinks.
Seconds of this
no
song,
way,
I'm,
man. American Woman stinks. American Woman stinks.
And another thing, Bobby, hold on, my kids are making noise.
Shut up!
And don't get me wrong, I think American Woman stinks too, and they got a great ball club over there, but at the end of the day,
I mean, it's just Fly Away is gonna run with it, and I don't even think it's close.
Lloyd, Fly Away or American Woman? What song stinks more? So it's safe to say that tonight's game is a toss-up. The only thing we are sure of is that this is the first ever football game that's being played by two bad songs. Now we're gonna head down to the sidelines where our very own Andrew Jones is down on the field. Jones, man, how's the energy down there? Have you had a chance to talk to any of the players or the coaches?
Yeah, I just talked to Coach Kravitz a couple minutes ago. He was loose. He was excited. He's feeling good about this. I mean, I think from his perspective, he's put the work in. He wrote a terrible song. He covered a terrible song. So one way or the other, one of those songs is going to come out on top here, and he's going to come out looking at this all right.
Great stuff. Now, with Flyaway being such heavy underdogs, what's Coach Kravitz saying to the players to keep them inspired?
You know, I talked to Coach Kravitz about that, and he says he knows they're an underdog coming in. There's no doubt about that, but they just got to go out there, play Flyaway football. They got to stick to their game, not worried about what American Woman is doing, and the rest is going to take care of itself.
Now, Jones, man, both of these teams want to go out there and get this W. What do you see as being the biggest key to this game?
Probably the biggest key to this game is going to be the bass. American Woman has no bass for about half the song, and that just sounds awful. I think Coach Kravitz has something up his sleeve there with Fly Away, where he might respond with, instead of no bass at all, he might go bass with a terrible wah effect on it for half the song, which in a lot of ways is worse than no bass at all. It's really a chess match.
Top-notch analysis as always, Jones, man. I think we're in for a good one. How about you, buddy?
This is going to be a lot of fun. Let's just sit back and watch.
Now, we're going to get right back to the Kravitz Bowl, but first, we're excited to announce a new series coming to the G-Chord Prime Network. We all know Rig Rundown. John Bollinger's been interviewing our favorite guitar players for years, but there's so many other professions that need to be run down. So this fall, G-Chord Prime is taking him off the stage to see what he can do in a new series called John Bollinger Department Store Rundown. John Bollinger here. What year are those pants?
Now?
Cool, man. I mean, I used to have a pair of those. So, are there tens on there?
No idea, man.
Cool. So we're at the jackets now. How long have you had this one?
For a little bit now, a little bit.
Cool. Now, are you playing like Ernie Balls? Or are you playing D'Addario's? Like, who are you playing?
What? What are you talking about?
Awesome. So how long have, like, you had this jacket right here?
Kind of new. You want to put one on you?
Yeah, I'll try one on. Sure, let's see what it sounds like. I feel like I used to have this color. It sounds great.
Dude, it sounds really great.
Is this rosewood or maple?
It's rosewood and maple.
Oh, awesome. Well, I gotta tell you, I'm looking forward to that on G-Chord Prime. And speaking of looking forward to things, let's talk about the Kravitz Bowl Halftime Spectacular featuring the debut performance of the new supergroup HCA. You're not gonna wanna miss that, folks. Well, hot dog, that about does it here for us at Countdown to Kickoff. We'd like to thank you for spending your time with us. We only have one more thing to say. Hey, pass the nachos over here, cause it's time for the Kravitz Bowl. Ladies and gentlemen, we are mere seconds away from kickoff, and let me tell you, Beato Coliseum is a rockin'. These fans are rowdy and ready, and they're hoping that Finnerty's got a bag of flags to throw at their team. Remember, folks, this ain't regular football. Both teams are gonna be jockeying to get as many penalty flags as they can. Now let's go down to obligatory female sideline correspondent, Kim. Kim, what can we expect out of both of these ball clubs in the first quarter?
Yeah, I talked to both Coach Kravitz's, and American Woman is confident with their game plan. Coach said they just need to execute. Now on the flyaway side of the field, they're gonna be aggressive. Coach said they want to dictate the pace of this game, and it's simply gonna come down to a matter of execution.
Great stuff. I have two more questions for you, Kim. How come every time I talk to you, I get Hot Stuff by Donna Summer stuck in my head? And speaking of, looks a little warm down there on the sidelines. Have you thought about maybe taking off that coat? Fair enough. Now let's head down to ref Pat Finnerty, who's got today's rules of the game. Hey, how's it going? Pat Finnerty. Let's bring in both captains from the team. Team American Woman, Team Fly Away. Ladies and gentlemen, here are the rules to the Kravitz Bowl. So for scoring today, we're going to be using the Hoffman point system. In each quarter, both teams are going to be fighting to win the Hoffman. What's that, Lenny? Oh, like a Hoffman is a point. I'm just calling it a Hoffman. He's the guy with the hard hat and the beer.
Hold on a second, Lenny. I guess this is the best time to talk about it. People ask me all the time, they're like, who's the old man in the hard hat with the white beard that's in all your videos? It's Jack Hoffman from Discovery Channel's Gold Rush Alaska. It's a bunch of assholes go looking for gold. They never get it. All their shit breaks down. It's a terrible show. You should check it out. But there's amazing men on this show. You got Gene Cheeseman. You got Tony Beats. But my favorite, obviously, Jack Hoffman. Honestly, I haven't watched the show in like 5 years, but I still can't get enough of the guy, man. I mean, look at him. Incredible look. Ridiculous voice.
This is hot stuff.
Awesome. He also claims that he could smell gold.
I always say I can smell gold. I can smell it here.
Smell it, Scott.
So I'm glad that we can finally have this conversation, and yeah, he's our points tonight.
So there will be four quarters of play. Each quarter will be a different section of the song. The first quarter is going to be intros, second quarter verses, third quarter choruses, fourth quarter solos. In each quarter, both teams will have one possession each to prove that their part stinks more. Whatever part stinks more gets the Hoffman. Whoever has the most Hoffmans at the end of the game will win the Kravitz Bowl and will be crowned ultimate Sultans of Stink. Any questions? That makes sense, right? And now it's time for the pick toss. American Woman, would you like Tortex up or Tortex down? Tortex up it is. Tortex down, fly away. Would you like to receive the ball? Or would you like to very well? Fly away will receive the ball. So fly away is going to take the ball, and just like that, we are underway here at Beato Coliseum. It's first down, and fly away intro has the ball. You're going to wait. Why not go around two more times on those power chords? Wait four times to kick it in.
Oh, come on. They got a flag for that?
Right there. Just kick it in. No, he makes us wait around again. It's like he's like he knows. He's like, no. I'm going to make you wait to hear the amount of nothing that I'm about to play for you for the next 4 minutes. I mean, if the song did anything but those four chords, I probably wouldn't have thrown a flag. But it doesn't do anything else. Just kick it in. I don't know, man. Flyaway's looking good for a Hoffman, but this is going to be a tough game to call because it's 8 seconds in and I'm pissed. So pretty much a three and out for the Flyaway intro, and you got to think the coaches were hoping for a longer possession than that. But who knows? Short and sweet might get the Hoffman. Let's take a look at tonight's starting lineups for both Flyaway and American Woman.
Lenny Kravitz, looks, vocals, guitar. Craig Ross, Noel Redding, Howard Stern-looking guitar dude.
Jimbo Diggins, defensive coordinator.
Okay, it's first down for the American Woman intro. Let's take it back down to the field.
They're good, man. This stinks. I know.
What the heck? I mean, in 10 seconds, he took away everything that's good about American Woman, which is mostly the fuzz guitar solo. Now, he claims that he didn't do this part because he couldn't get the tone right, you know, because it's hard to find a fuzz pedal. It's like, you know, so just to show you guys, I plugged in the Joyo Ultimate Drive. Guess what it sounds like? Fuzz. It's not even a fucking fuzz pedal. It's a shitty $25 overdrive. All you have to do is just turn the gain up and go on your neck pickup. Beato. No, that's more Shoal. What's next? Under pressure, but let's get rid of that bass part. Get it out of there. I was thinking maybe Satisfaction, but like, that always kind of got in the way, you know? So let's get that out of there. The fucking A. I don't even know why I'm talking about this, though. All we have to do is just listen to the... This stinks, and Flyaway intro stunk too,
But I'm pretty sure that even if it went around four times on the intro, I don't think I'm giving it to Hoffman over this. American Woman put it on the board. An American Woman puts the first Hoffman on the board! And just like that, American Woman strikes first and puts a Hoffman on the board, and these flyaway fans are not happy about this call. Either is Coach Kravitz. He's up in arms on the sideline, and I think he might even be thinking about challenging this one. This early in the game, you can't think he's going to throw his one challenge flag, but he does! Coach Kravitz throws the red challenge. He wants to take another look. So Flyaway wants Finnerty to take another look at this one. They say that their intro stinks more. And by they, it looks like it's just Coach Kravitz on this one. Quick look at the sideline, and you can see defensive coordinator Jimbo Diggins and assistant coach Craig Ross are not happy about this challenge flag being thrown. I don't think they think this thing could be turned around. Let's go to our very own rules analyst, Mike Pereira, out in Los Angeles. Mike, what do you see on this play?
I'm seeing two times through on the intro, and the referee said that's not enough. I don't think anything's going to be on the video here that's going to change their mind. I've looked at every angle. I've slowed it down.
He's making us wait twice.
Two times through, that's what's on the video.
But even if it went around four times on the intro, I don't think I'm giving it to Hoffman over this.
I don't see anything clear and convincing that would give them enough to overturn. It looks like American Woman stinks more and the call on the field should stand.
Great stuff. Let's take it down to Finnerty with the call. After reviewing the play, the call on the field stands.
Christ, I told him, do not throw the flag!
Yes, the flyaway intro stinks, but American Woman didn't do the fuzz guitar. But what do you want from me?
Oh, fuck yeah!
And the call stands, and you gotta think, wow, Flyaway just lost their one and only challenge flag. That could come into play at the end of the game. So we'll see about that, but let's get back to the action. It's the second quarter, which means the verses are up and American Woman has the ball. Vocal, whoa! Song, slow! What we love about dumb rock and roll is dudes singing high. You get a good riff, the dude sings high. I don't know why we want it, but that's what we want. You know, American Woman's in the key of E. American Woman! Rips. He's doing this in C. I mean, imagine Bob Plant singing how many more times in A? How many more times? No. He's not even doing that five before the legato. But I mean, like, but he just does. He man in the box is it. Instead of going. Why wouldn't you do the. Why wouldn't you do any of it? It's gotta be a Hoffman, but I don't know. Flyaway's coming up. Let's see what they do. And wow, was American Woman moving the chains on that possession. I mean, they're looking good for their second Hoffman already. This could be a blowout. But I've certainly been wrong before, like when I bet my buddy $100 at the Bare Naked Ladies concert that Pinch Me was gonna be the first encore. I mean, how don't you come back out with Pinch Me? You got him eating out of the palm of your hands, you come back out and hit him with Pinch Me. I thought it was a lock. But I'll take a roof-raising rendition of If I Had $1 Million whenever they want to play it, so good money spent. Let's fly a waves ball now. Let's see what they do with the verse. I wish that I could fly into the sky, so very high, just like a dragonfly. I mean, there's already two flies. There's a very involved, just like a dragonfly. Come on, Lenny. I've never paid that much attention, but I'm all right with Beatles, Lenny. I'm all right with Lenny Gay. I'm all right with Led Lenny Hendrix. But this is like third grade your mom puts it on the refrigerator shit. This is you just got a off and we got a tie game shit is what it is. Put it on the board. Yeah! Wowie zowie, Flyaway strikes back and puts a Hoffman on the board, and we've got a tie game going into the half. Couldn't ask for much more than this, folks. Now let's head back to the sidelines where Andrew Jones is with Flyaway defensive coordinator Jimbo Diggins.
I'm down here with Jimbo Diggins, defensive coordinator for Flyaway. Coach Diggins, the intro, any second guessing on that one?
I don't feel comfortable answering that question.
Christ, I told him, do not throw the flag!
But we talked to Coach Kravitz about that. We're going to make some adjustments going into the second half.
You got to feel good about the second quarter, though. Your guys bounced back. You feel like this team's got a chip on his shoulder?
Look it, we're going to go up there, we're going to play hard, we're going to execute.
Understood. You think they took it personal that you guys were an underdog coming in?
We never called ourselves an underdog.
You think you really got a shot in this one?
How much ball game is left? Of course we got a shot.
All right, Coach, thanks so much for your time. I know you got to get back in there and coach those guys up.
Yeah, I got to get back to my team. Thank you.
All right, back to you guys in the booth.
Great stuff. Sounds like that coach wants to make some adjustments and win the game. It's a good thing we interviewed him. Coming up next, the Halftime Spectacular featuring the new supergroup HCA. And let me tell you, you're not going to want to miss this, folks. We'll catch you on the other side.
Up next, the Kravitz Bull Halftime Spectacular brought to you by these guitar stands. Thinking about putting your guitar down? Think again. These guitar stands, there's nothing worse. And Bandcamp. Your friends have to listen to half of one of your songs somewhere. Bandcamp.
The Kravitz Bull Halftime Spectacular starts in 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back, folks, and it is now the second half of the Kravitz Bowl. You just enjoyed HCA, and now you can jump over to HCARocks.com and use promo code Kravitz Bowl and save 10% on their debut album, Jackhammer. Great band. But back to business, it's the third quarter, which means the choruses are up and American Woman has the ball. Let's head down to Affinity.
American Woman, listen what I say. American Woman!
That harmony blows. I love harmony. Love the Beatles, love the Beach Boys, love Motown, love the Everly Brothers. But this harmony stinks.
And there's a reason why the Guess Who didn't put a harmony over that. Because it's a scumbag riff, they sang it high, and it sounded good. I mean, there's good scumbag, there's bad scumbag. Good scumbag's like Come Together Scumbag. Scumbag riff, right? But like the Beatles, they sing low under it, because if you put that high third over it, you're gonna get this.
Because it's a beagle, moving up slowly, beagle.
No. Or like War Pigs, you know, like these are songs that like harmonies actually make it rock less.
Gathered in their masses, just like witches at black masses.
I mean, it doesn't sound like shit, but it sounds like shit. You gotta be careful. I mean, it's better than a Bush harmony. Bush harmonies are bad. When's the last time you heard Calm Down?
What do you say? Do you do? When it all comes down.
So he takes away all the fun stuff, the drums, the bass, the fuzz guitar, and just adds that shitty harmony. Now let's talk about the lyrics for a second here. Now Lenny didn't write this song, but have you seen the Guess Who? I mean, when they sing American Woman, Stay Away From Me, like, I believe them. These guys look like they just want to eat a ham steak and watch a hockey game.
So it makes sense when they sing it. And this song could also be viewed as an anti-war protest song, but we're going to bypass that whole angle because I don't think Lenny was thinking about the Ho Chi Minh Trail when he was laying down this cut.
So what we're left with is to believe that this man does not seek the company of an American woman. He doesn't seek the company of any woman. He says, get away from me. I don't care what fucking nationality they are. This is what this guy looks like when he's making coffee. He's walking cologne.
Absolutely.
He sleeps in leather. I mean, like, are you telling me that the man left his essential oils at home when he knew that Heather Graham was going to be on the set? There's no way. I guarantee he was trying to work it with Graham. And who knows? Is Graham gonna say no to Kravitz? She's seen the pick.
Fuck yeah, coach, we got the pick on our possession. Let's go!
I was firing that thing out, man, when it first came out. I mean, people were asking me if I wanted to go to lunch. I was like, yeah, I'll go, Lanny. Like, hey, man, can you play this show? Yeah, I can play it, Lanny. Oh, God, I just remembered something. I actually sent it to this old guy that I used to give guitar lessons to. That was a tough text. I mean, there's a lot of mics in your phone. He was Mike Guitar. And like I said, I mean, I was bombing people with that thing. What am I gonna do? It's fucking Lenny Kravitz, full on rock, screaming, fucking balls out. You know, like I wasn't gonna send that thing everywhere. Our thread was like, can you make the lesson? Yeah, I'm good for it. Can you make the lesson? Yeah, I'm good for it. Lenny Kravitz, dick pic. That's a tough text. That was a tough one. I don't know what I did after that. I don't know how I dug myself out. That's a flag on the ref. It's a flag on the ref for that one.
An American woman just proves why they're the favorite in this match. They matriculated right down the field, folks. They put on a clinic there. Talk about a flag fest. Even the ref got a flag at the end of that possession. If I got a flag for every time I sent out a pick old champ here, I'd be buried alive. I don't think there's a cell tower in the lower 48 that old champ ain't been through. Ain't that right, old champ? Aerial coverage of the Kravitz Bulls brought to you by the new hit game show, Green Day or Rascal Flatts. Is it Green Day or is it Rascal Flatts? The Flyaway Chorus will have the ball when we return after this.
Everybody's been loving the new hit game show, Green Day or Rascal Flatts, but it gets even better, because next week the celebrities are here. Sorry, Mr. Barker, it was Green Day. Now to Hank Williams Jr., and your final question will be an upstairs or downstairs.
Oh, hot dang it, not upstairs, downstairs.
Who's downstairs? Is it Green Day or is it Rascal Flatts?
Green Day.
Oh, sorry, Hank, it was Rascal Flatts.
Ah, should've known Mike Dern ain't gonna wear that vest, but Trey Cool got me fresh off my scent. Hot dang it.
Available only on the new streaming app, G-Chord Ultra. G-Chord Ultra, you like logging in, right?
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. It's Flyaway Chorus's ball now, and they're gonna try to answer that clinic that American Woman just put on. The Hoffman's up for grabs. Whoever gets the next one will have a commanding 2-1 lead going into the fourth. Let's see what happens.
Do you, Lenny?
Flag.
Then get away. Fly away on your private plane to like Brazil, where I'm pretty sure you own like a part of the country. I saw some show where, you know, he's got this huge estate and he's on a horse, hanging out in this like bungalow that's bigger than any house I'll ever own. Like, just fly away there, you know? Don't just tell us that you're flying away and say yeah, unless it rips. I mean, I'm not a fucking sociopath. Of course he's gotta scream yeah, and you gotta scream come on, and you gotta do all the dumb shit in rock and roll rules. Or like the Stooges, come on! Come on! Come on! I mean, but that track rules. But if your track sounds something like... For 5 minutes, I mean, you better tell me some sort of a story. And Tom Petty, to find a friend. In the middle of his life, he left his wife, ran off to be bad. Boy, it was sad. You know, bought a new car, found a new bar. The fucking guy was getting divorced. I mean, he was getting away. But he told us about it. We at least knew what he was doing. Not Lenny. He's just saying, like, maybe let's go to the Milky Way. You know, like, he can't even commit to a galaxy. Flag. I mean, like, he doesn't even tell us what planet he wants to go to. No, he does. He says, or even Mars. I know I'm not supposed to be talking about the verses right now, but I mean, like...
Time out! Time out!
Like, let's go see the stars, the Milky Way, or even Mars. I mean, he sends a shot at Mars, which is actually the best line in the song. And then we got the yes! You know, I mean, the Yaz and Flyaway are getting real close to the haze of Hey Soul Sister. I'll bring it back to HSS, don't think that I won't. But like, I don't want to miss a single thing you do tonight. Hey, I want to fly away, yeah. So, I mean, like, that's tough company, Lenny. Come on, Lenny. Needless to say, that's a Hoffman. Fly away scores the Hoffman.
Yeah! 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 Yeah!
And Hot Dog Flyaway puts the go-ahead Hoffman on the board, and they're up 2-1. But folks, there might be a little controversy surrounding this Hoffman. I'll explain. You might have noticed that our production team cut over to the American Women's sideline during that last flyaway possession, and here's why. During Team Flyaway's Hoffman-winning chorus drive, Ref Finnerty started talking about the flyaway verse.
I know I'm not supposed to be talking about the verses right now, but I mean like...
Which of course was illegal and should have been called back. Here's where it gets interesting. While Ross is trying to signal for timeout...
Timeout! Timeout!
Ref Finnerty has his hands over his eyes in disbelief of how bad the flyaway verse lyrics are.
Oh, even Mars?
You can't blame him for that, but he missed the timeout and therefore American Woman couldn't challenge the play. Now Coach Kravitz's piercing artist had just showed up, so he was nowhere to be found during this whole thing. Only time will tell if it impacts the final outcome of the game, and that's what we got coming up next, everybody. It's the fourth quarter, it's the solos, it's the stunning conclusion of the Kravitz Bowl on the other side.
You know, what year is this, man?
Year what?
Do you mind if we take a look at your board?
What board you want to look at, bud?
This is called a rug, my man. Are you okay?
Do you put the Wawa in the first of your signal chain or at the end?
I guess at the end.
Cool. Pillows over there. Are those 10s or 11s?
These are 12s.
Whoa, 12s. Cool.
You're really working to bend that G on there,
12s.
Aren't you?
Yeah.
Cool, man.
Are those lollers in there?
I don't think so. I think they're Wimbers.
Oh, cool. That's great, man. Well, I'm really looking forward to the show tonight.
What show?
Ladies and gentlemen, we've now reached the fourth quarter. All right, we got the solo coming up now. Brought it down. Like it wasn't low enough. He brings it down more. Songs in C. Solo B. And he's not doing the... Let's get the pedal mobile going. It's the fourth quarter. What is he doing? Let's hear it. Good decision, Lenny.
You know, we have never heard that before.
Like, listen, I've said it before, I'll say it again. Blues licks are fucking fine, man. Everybody plays them. It's great. Whatever. But when you have that, fucking do it. Don't just go. Take it back up halfway. The solo's moving, man. Kind of does an Ohio move there. Stills. I will say this, he is accurately playing this blues solo in the video, which like isn't that easy to do. I mean, he remembered the blues legs. That's like remembering those are kind of hard, exactly what you did, but he's got it. Check it out. Like he's doing it to us, man. Like he's fucking bringing it. Like holy shit. And why is there drums in this video? There's no drums. I mean, that is gratuitous hardware. I've played so many gigs. I'm not a drummer. I've had to carry so many fucking hi-hats and hi-hat stands and kick drums and put them in the back of my car and they punch in the leather. There's a drum machine hi-hat and a snap in this song. There's toms in this video. Fuck. And a gutsy possession from American Woman when they needed it the most, folks. Remember, they're down to Hoffman. They needed to bring everything they had, and they did. They gotta be happy with that possession. A lot happier than I am in my profanity football league. I started shithead today. He hasn't said it once. Let's check the profanity football league leaders. Hopefully you guys did a little better than me.
Fuck. Like, holy shit. It's fucking...
It's good scumbag, it's bad scumbag.
Fucking guy was getting divorced.
I mean, it doesn't sound like shit, but it sounds like shit.
Okay, folks, let's set the scene. It's Flyaway's last possession.
If they win the Hoffman, they win the Kravitz Bowl. If American Woman can hold them off, they tie and we go to overtime.
It doesn't get more exciting than this, folks. What solo stinks more? Is it the American Woman solo or is it the Flyaway solo? Let's go down to the field. Let's see what Flyaway does.
There's Refinity and American Woman on the field, but where's Flyaway? And how about that? A little theatrics from Fly Away. The underdogs are trying a little something special in the fourth quarter. I don't know if it's working, though. American Woman doesn't seem too impressed.
Fancy look, boys, but it's going to take a lot more than a V formation to beat us.
You tell them, Craig. All right, American Woman, that's enough of that. Fly Away, the field is yours.
Okay, it's first down, Fly Away, and the solo section is just about to come on. And the snap.
And it's a fake! It's a fake solo. Fly Away has faked the solo, and now the guitar is flying away out of the Auto Coliseum. American Woman is baffled. There is nothing happening in this section of the song. Finity doesn't know what to make of this.
Ladies and gentlemen, I didn't realize that Flyaway doesn't have a guitar solo. So I'm going to need a rest timeout on this one to figure out what the hell I'm going to do. So Finity's got to think about it. And while he does, let's take another look at that fake solo play. I was sure they were going to run it right up the middle with the bullshit solo, but no, the snap, the one note, hands in the air. They don't have a guitar. Where is it? It's out of the Coliseum. And you got to think that's a Jimbo Diggins designed play. You got to remember, he was one of the engineers on the Flyaway session in 98, and he told Lenny, no solo, no solo. A good offense is a great defense. Steve, let's get a shot of Finity now. Let's see how he's doing. And you can see he's struggling to make sense of this situation. My question is why? Flyaway played one note and threw the guitar onto the Coliseum, leaving us with the same repetitive bass line we've already been hearing for 2.5 minutes. I'm an asshole and I know that stinks. Well, it looks like he made his decision. Let's head down to the field. Flyaway only has one note in its guitar solo. And it's actually my favorite part of both of these songs. Seriously, this is the only section in both of these songs that our ears aren't under constant attack by these fucking brain-bashing power chords and the man screaming, yeah, get away and fly away. And yeah, the one note was the tonic beato. And he could have picked a more interesting note if there's only going to be one note. And yeah, it highlights the auto wah and the envelope filter of the bass, but that's hilarious. Now don't get me wrong, this section stinks, but it does showcase the kind of cool drum beat that's in Fly Away.
Cindy Blackman, cool drummer.
So this section of the song actually sounds good because there's like no music happening. But American Woman sounds like shit. I think I'm right. This is a tougher call than Shepard versus Lang in the Asshole Invitational. Maybe I'd change my mind if I saw the play again, but I don't know how the no fuzz guitar solo doesn't get the Hoffman. American Woman gets the fourth quarter solo. Hoffman, put it on the board.
It's American Woman! It's American Woman! American Woman wins the Hoffman, and we've got a tie game! And this place needs to be hosed down! American Woman is jamming on the sidelines, and their fans are going crazy. Meanwhile, the Flyaway fans don't know what just happened. And there goes the clipboard, and Kravitz is off the rails on the sideline. Now he wants a timeout to try to challenge this thing. But remember, folks, he can't challenge this play. They already used their challenge in the first quarter. If only they could. You got to figure this play could get reversed. The blame might be on Coach Kravitz for this one. And speaking of the devil, there's Craig Ross, and he's letting Kravitz have it.
I've been laying out of that fucking section for 20 years, and now we can't challenge it because you blew it.
And Kravitz fires Ross.
Christ, I told him, do not throw the flag.
Diggins is irate! And now Diggins is getting into it with Kravitz.
God damn it, I never listen! God damn it!
And now Kravitz is giving Diggins the suck it!
Yeah.
And now Kravitz fires Diggins!
And not the most sportsmanlike exit from Jimbo Diggins, but tensions are running high. And now the Flyaway fans are calling for Finnerty's head.
Hey, how about this? Fuck yourself, Stinks, Finnerty!
I might be next. Good thing I'm almost off the clock.
I didn't think this game was gonna tie!
Scumbag!
You got any ideas for overtime up in the booth?
No can do, compadre. I'd love to help you out, but I've got a date with the prime rib in 15 minutes, and it looks like I lost my wedding ring again.
No, I left my keys in there.
How am I going to get back in? They're going to eat me alive.
Me. Keys?
I'm out. I'm in.
It's me, the ref. I'm in disguise. I changed the light in the back. I'm sorry.
I gotta be honest with everybody. I don't know what song stinks more.
I don't.
I tried. And the reason why is because I think Fly Away is the worst song, but I think American Woman is harder to listen to. I don't know if that makes sense, but I think it makes sense. I mean, and I'm not alone. I even did an Instagram poll and American Woman got 55% of the vote. And I did a Patreon poll and Fly Away won 55% of the vote. Patreon, who said that? But, you know, numbers are numbers. I gotta hear it from the mouth. You know, anyone could just do that, but you really gotta think about this thing. So I'm gonna go on Instagram Live. It's an Instagram Live overtime. And because both of these songs were on the album 5, that's our number. So I'm going to talk to strangers. I'm going to ask the Flyaway American Woman what song stinks more. And the first of 5 is going to win the Kravitz Bowl. So put it on the Jumbotron. I'm going on Instagram Live right now. Holy shit. What's your name? Where are you?
Joey, basement in Portland.
American Woman or Fly Away? What song stinks more?
I would say American Woman stinks more.
Okay, so that's one for woman. Mick Francis, you're up next. Mick Francis, bass. What are the chances that Mick Francis is a bass player? Hey, Mick Francis, are you a bass player by chance?
I am a bass player.
You know what's amazing about bass players is that you guys could just sit down in a room and play bass, and like you're happy.
Yeah, it's rhythmic, it's notes, it's everything.
Yeah. Hey, I love the bass, but it's weird that you're a bass player. Say it.
It's kind of weird.
Yeah, it is. It's weird. But you're in a very dark room. I need to get to business here, though. What song stinks more?
Fly Away.
Ooh, Fly Away's on the board.
I gotta go with Fly Away.
Fly Away, up 2-1. Look out.
Yeah, just the fact that the chorus is just, yeah, like...
That's a good point.
Fly Away gets to me more.
I don't disagree. Yeah. Like, you could have told me American Woman gets to you more. I would have been like, yeah.
I don't know what it is about it. It's just a little more annoying. American Woman, at least I'm like, oh, well, I get what he's doing.
Yeah, I don't. But I mean, I kind of get what you're saying. Are you high right now?
A little, yeah.
Yeah, he's high. Hard's for him being high.
I'm voting for American Woman.
Oh, American Woman making a little bit of a comeback. So it's 3-2.
It's Justin, I'm from Melbourne, Australia.
Fuck yeah, we got Australia back. The Australian everybody, we're down under. What song stinks more?
I think it's American Woman. It's just atrocious. It's horrible.
Keep talking.
I don't want
to listen to it. I mean, either do I. Either do I, man, Australian man. Either do I. Who's in next? What about Eric Jones? Let's get Eric Jones in here. Are you Eric Jones?
Yeah.
Nice job, where are you?
I'm in Austin, Texas.
What do you got?
It's American Woman.
Wow. And he said it like Thor. That was like you just declared it American Woman.
Pretty easily, yeah.
You're right, and you might be wrong. I don't know. It's American Woman just took the lead, 4-3. Eric Austin, go Longhorns. Nice job. Thanks for calling in. Oh, man, look at that ridiculous Maryland flag. If anybody doesn't know, that actually is the Maryland flag. Show them again. It's a colorblind toddler. Came up with that. Where are you taking us? It's 4-3 American Woman. What's the worst song, American Woman or Fly Away? The man from Baltimore now has the floor.
Gotta say Fly Away.
Oh man, it's tied up! 4-4! Unreal!
The child wrote it, just the lyrics are just so bad.
I already said that in the video. I'm not even gonna put this video out. All right, so here it is. 4-4, whoever the next call is, it's gonna decide.
What's up, bud?
Here we go. We're in the darkness, and it's a good thing we are. All right.
It's a pretty easy decision, man.
Hold on. Don't give it away yet. Don't give it away yet. Let me get the lights down low with you here. Out of respect.
All right.
So what the hell's your name?
My name's Jim.
Jim, you're in Ohio. We're neighbors, right?
We sure are.
What song stinks more? It's all up to you, Jim.
Okay, so listen. Here's how I'm going to explain this. So, American Woman is a cover, you know.
Yeah.
Not a bad song. Fly Away is a terrible song.
So you're saying Fly Away right now?
Oh, absolutely.
Fly Away takes it home. Fly Away wins. I'll tell you what. I thought that it was going to be easy American Woman for me. Easy. But then the more and more I listen to Fly Away, I think I'm with you, Jim. Ladies and gentlemen, I got called back in. I was at my regular table at Amici's, and let me tell you, there were no Hoffmans thrown at Amici's tonight. Chef was on point. Actually, you know, I did have to give one Hoffman to my server, Amber. Excuse me, Amber, I couldn't help but notice that my steak won't cool down because you keep walking past it. Huh? Fair enough. Well, my old friend Brazzers, looks like it's me and you again tonight. And then I drive back to the Coliseum to find out that Finnerty has still not given out the final Hoffman, and remarkably, nobody's left the Coliseum. They want to know who's going to win the Kravitz Bowl. Who knows how long this is going to take? Let's check back in with Finnerty. Ladies and gentlemen, I appreciate your patience. Seriously, I can't believe you're still watching this thing. This is so fucking stupid. I haven't given Fly Away the win because I can't stop thinking about something that happened at the end of overtime. Kick, snare, pat. I think I'm with you, Jim. And I agree with them. We've gone this far, and I feel like we still haven't had a definitive winner. And I don't even trust myself at this point. I mean, they both stink so much. I don't think I can make the call. If only there was a person that could just answer this question absolutely, and that I can't deny. I would need a pure entity, someone who's got like a godlike disposition. But I mean, this never gonna happen. The person doesn't exist. Or do they?
Hey, what the fuck is this? Now what?
Tough road ahead of
us. It's a Blinds to Go Guy!
And out of nowhere, Finnerty calls in the Blinds to Go Guy from the Weezer Beverly Hills What Makes This Song Stink video.
Tough road ahead of us.
Finnerty wants to end this thing, so he's bringing in the top brass.
Tough road ahead of us.
Blinds to Go Guy.
You got him.
Thank God you answered. I need you. The Kravitz Bowl tied, and then I went on Instagram, and I didn't feel great about it. So I got to ask you a question. What song stinks more, Fly Away or American Woman?
Oh, man. All right, well, Fly Away was in those Nissan ads. You know, who doesn't hate a Nissan? American Woman was in Austin Powers. You know, classically overrated movie, honestly.
I'm still on Who Doesn't Hate a Nissan.
So I remember back in the day, you know, these Nissan commercials flooded my TV.
Yeah.
I don't drive a Nissan. I drive a Mazda. I don't need a Nissan. I don't need to hear Lenny Kravitz 17 times a day. Especially when I'm trying to watch the wheel. The wheel's on. I'm trying to guess the answer, and they go to commercial, and I have to hear Fly Away.
Right.
I don't want to hear that.
Yeah, so you're bringing in the Wheel of Fortune Mazda defense.
Yeah, I mean, it's a classic one, but I think it's going to work here.
I think we got to go with it at this point. I mean, I tried playing a football game and tied. I don't know what else to do. I mean, Mazda Wheel of Fortune kind of makes sense at this point, Blinds to Go Guy.
You did what you could do. I'm just giving my input as to what I think is the logical way to make sense of this.
Appreciate that.
That I can help.
Thanks a lot, Blinds to Go Guy. You're the man. Works for me. Flyway wins the fucking Kravitz Bowl. Finally got it.
And it's Flyway! Flyway takes the Kravitz Bowl! And the Dogs did it! The Underdogs did it! They came out and they proved that they were the team to beat! And the Blinds to Go Guys pull it up in the Mazda with Sajak and White!
And it's water under the bridge for Coach Kravitz, Diggins, and Ross as they're getting in the Mazda, and this place is going nuts! And as we all watch the Mazda ride off into the sunset together, we'd like to say thank you for watching, everybody. It's time for us to sign off here. For G-Corp Sports, I'm probably an asshole. And remember, thanks for watching. Don't click the link below.
What makes this song stink?
So, what can you tell me about this?
It's just a football. It's
gold. Cool.
It's gold.
What year is it?
I don't know, dude. It's just a football.
We don't work here.
Yeah, I don't know, man.
Oh, you guys don't work here. Either do I. Cool. Yeah. You know what the radius is on this thing? Is it a 7 1/4?
I don't work here.
Cool.